If the place where you are living and working is a sanctuary, you are a priest. Your eternal individuality is by nature a holy being. You imperatively have to uphold this dignity. The higher powers are close to you. You know the will of God. You convey it to others and enforce it on earth. You bestow divine gifts, truth, justice, beauty, and love. You take over the spiritual guidance in your home and in every other room you enter. In the world, wherever you appear, the hierarchy manifests itself. Your work is being carried out in the name and on behalf of the higher powers. You bring order to the chaos of the world. We are approaching the end of our broadcasting. Establishing an interior temple is not just a private pleasure to make your life more comfortable. When you create the atmosphere of a sacred place around you, this is at the same time service to the common good. You are dreaming of a world of beauty and harmony, where people get along well with each other and settle their disagreements by a loving dialogue rather than by strife or violence. Then create such a better world in your surroundings. Make every room you enter such a higher place. Draw people under the spell of your inner temple. They visit your place of residence or work, and thereby enter your holy world. Or you bring your heaven, your portable paradise, with you to them. Thereby you also transform the material level. This is very general, though. Can you give an example? In 1453, the Turks had conquered Constantinople and continued to advance westward. The rulers of Europe were unable to organize resistance. In this situation, 70-year-old Saint John of Capistrano alone collected an army of crusaders from ordinary people and decisively repelled the Turks in 1456 off Belgrade. He went down in history as the savior of the West, and his deed as the miracle of Belgrade. His military camp is described as a monastery. Mass was read. It was preached, confessed, and the sacraments administered daily. There was strict discipline. The spirit of the saint completely controlled the masses. They obeyed him like novices. The usual excesses of soldiers' life did not come up at all. The rough fellows said, "We are serving under a holy captain, hence we must behave properly." If Saint John of Capistrano was able to turn an entire military camp into a monastery, you too can set about making every room you enter a temple. In the broadcastings on the establishment of the new world, we shall discuss in more detail. Our task is to adapt the conditions on earth to those in heaven. The goal is the whole earth is to become a sanctuary. A planet on which everywhere, in any place, the will of God, or scientifically speaking, the will of the hierarchy, the cosmic order, prevails, on which the principles of the higher world, such as truth, justice, beauty, and love, are actually enforced. How can we make this high ideal a reality? The world of the future must first be created in the consciousness, in the hearts of people, which means, in scientific language, in heaven, in thought, on the subtle level. The old world and the new world are distinguished through consciousness, not by outer evidence. Age and circumstance bear no importance. The new world is born everywhere, but beyond boundaries and conditions. The establishment of the temple within is the first step to create the new world. The new city must be built first in the hearts of mankind, before it can be objectified on the physical plane. You must make paradise a reality, at least within yourself, before you can think of creating it in the outside world. How do you want to clear the earth of garbage when your own inner room is still filled with dirt? One has to provide the world with evidence. And isn't the temple of the spirit such evidence? If the whole earth is to become a sanctuary, we have to transform every single location on this planet into a temple. The more people establish an interior temple there where they are dwelling, the more the new world will emerge over time by itself. You remember, heaven is less a place than a community of soulmates. A paradise is a paradise because you are living among your own kind. Lower beings have no access here and cannot bother you. A heaven is created by spiritually related beings living together, according to common customs, traditions, rules, and laws. High-minded souls are gathering together in the hereafter to build holy places, cathedrals, ashrams, monasteries, and temples. If your eternal individuality belongs to such a sanctuary in the subtle world, that means you, your true self, are a member of such a supra-temporal community. Let us imagine a community of pure and holy spirits in white robes. Under the guidance of a wise master, they strengthen their soul with spiritual exercises and selflessly serve the common good with their daily work. In order to become and to remain a member of this supra-temporal community, you must, in all worlds, in heaven as well as on earth, live according to the same customs, do the same exercises, and serve the same goals. Then living together physically is not important. That is why the concept of the interior temple is sufficient to remain attached to your spiritual homeland. Of course, you carry this true family within your heart, which you had to leave for a short time, and to which you want to return as soon as possible. Of course, you stay in touch with your eternal brothers and sisters when you are away from home. We shall discuss more details in the broadcasting Living in the Ashram of the Teacher. Now, after so many words on my part, it's your turn. Set up your paradise and enjoy the happiness of living therein. And pass on the experiences you are making to other people so that they too can beautify their life. May everyone perceive.
Here is the new man. Here is the new world.